Okay, morning everyone. I have to say at 7 o'clock this morning, we thought we were going to be have an easy call on this one and it would be a scrub, but yeah, not so sure now. So I'm going to run through a briefing and we're just going to cover the essentials of the church notices and daily bits and pieces, and then a weather briefing. So once again, thanks to our sponsors for Endicom Prizes, Vertigo Covers, Vertigo Aviation Detailing, Apple Garth and G Dale and the Soaring Engine. And we'll talk more about those during the week. Quick reminder of the Wednesday night music night after flying in the clubhouse. It is an open mic night. Don't know how many people have volunteered yet, but contact Mark Davenport, who is here today. Other acts, we've got Catherine Futrell, Ken Barker and Mark's band Up to No Good. And just to cover what food we've got for tonight and tomorrow night. Tonight's hog roast served out under the marquee, and Wednesday's traditionally curry night for the Wednesday evening group, so that's going to carry on. I look forward to that. And over to Jordan for the weather.
Okay, good morning, everybody. Forecast for Tuesday, the 31st of May. Yes, where has the year gone? So low pressure is still in charge of the weather at the moment. And with that, we've been picking up a couple of trough lines, which you can see on the 12 o'clock synoptic for today. The position of those trough lines is causing us a bit of a headache, really, because in our opinion in here, we think they are actually a little bit further to the east of where it says on there, and that they're already sort of over us or just about to be. One thing I must point out, as it has been issued by the Met Office, is a weather warning for thunderstorms between 11 UTC and 1 UTC, which we'll keep an eye on. But other sort of weather warnings for today, and the pressure is quite low at 1,007 hectopascals currently. Still got a westerly wind over the UK currently. It's come a bit more round from south to west now. Flying heights 250 to 270, somewhere in the region around 15 knots. Satellite picture over the UK shows the trough, which is this sort of line running from about Weymouth up towards Oxfordshire, which I think is about an hour to an hour and a half in front of where it should be. There is this gap behind, and today rests on what happens behind this trough and whether it starts to spark even bigger showers. At the moment, there is evidence that there is a bit of shower activity in the vicinity of Bristol, but not particularly severe and potentially taskable. The TAFs at the moment are obviously pre-trough, but at the moment, it's showing that we should get a 3,000 foot base at some point today. Shower risk all day, but we look at this and we can see prob 30 of severe thunderstorms with gusts up to 25 knots. Again, prob 30, so hopefully quite a low chance, but nevertheless, we are taking that into account for today. And that appears very much the same in the Southampton TAF also, but again, scattered at 3,000 feet. This is the Lark Hill at 6Z this morning. You can see how unstable it is and how much cloud there is. So it's not particularly surprising that we are getting shower activity. But the reason that we are holding on a bit is I need to see some more data and what's behind this trough before we can really make an educated decision. And hopefully that data will come in shortly. Give you a picture of what's happening over the west and southwest currently. Trough line has sort of been breaking up as it approaches, though we are seeing some CB activity over Southampton, which is, I look out the window, it is quite dark and I keep my fingers crossed it's not coming this way. But with the winds as they are, we should be okay and this line should pass through us. You can see little splidges and splodges of showers out there. Not really that significant, but we will be keeping an eye on that for the rest of the morning. Top temperature today of 14 degrees and dew points sitting around sort of 8 or 9 at the moment for the forecast. Just have a quick look at David's weather station, just give you what's going on at the moment. Have 11.8 degrees and 7.1. It's fluctuating a bit as the sun keeps going behind the clouds and these showers approach. On to the data then. So we'll go for potential flight distance, first of all, which shows the best tasking area for today being down towards the west of Solent zone out towards Salisbury. So any tasks we set are likely to be in that direction. Around sort of 2 to 3 o'clock, with that trough pass is maybe a little bit tricky around here, but much better out in the task area. And it just continues to improve from there. Nothing particularly strong, maybe 2 to 3 knot thermals, so weak, but doable. You've all been spoiled a bit with the weather on Saturday. Q cloud base looking in that region around sort of 3,500 feet, maybe getting up to 4 later in the day towards the Bournemouth zone. And cloud cover, as you can see here, sort of fairly mixed. We will be doing a bit more on the weather a bit later, so we'll come on to that. But overdevelopments, as you can see, is going to be a factor today to take in with these showers. So, yes, but we are just hoping for a little bit more sun on the ground and a bit more soluble weather. Give you an idea on rain. So let's have a look. So that's the showers that's going through at the moment. Behind that, as you can see, is the risk of more showers, but we're hoping most of the time that stays clear of the task areas. I don't think there's particularly much more data I can show, which is particularly useful, if I'm honest. As I said, we just need to look out the window and see what actually happens. However, I will show some predicted soundings with the weather at 3:30 in the task area, showing that we would get reasonable climbs up to around 4,000 feet in there. And we'll have a look at top meteo as well, just to sense check. Not that top meteo is always that full of sense, but again, reasonable down to the southwest. Unfortunately, we can't get used to that nice area near Plymouth. That would be a bit of a challenge. Starting at 10 o'clock, this top meteo is slightly under predicting shower volumes. As you go through the day, we're seeing sort of cloud bases varying between about 3,000 and 3,500 feet. But as we get to around 3 o'clock, it perks up again in the southwest corner with cloud base again showing around 4,000 to 4,500 feet and sort of stabilizing out a bit to reduce the shower risk. Finally, location forecast for today. So after lunch, showing sort of 3,300 feet above Lasham, climbs to sort of 3 knots or so. Still that risk of showers and yeah, just mixed. So I think to sum up today, we are hopeful, but we need to see some more data, but it's certainly better than yesterday. And that's the weather at the moment. Back to Colin.
Okay, everybody, here's the plan of attack. There'll be another Zoom briefing at 12:30 local. Any decisions that we make before that will be notified via text. If we think this trough line has gone through and we want you to grid, we'll notify you by text. But we'll rebrief at 12:30. We'll have, if we think it's taskable, we'll have airspace and task briefings with a weather update. and we'll take it from there. So hopefully we'll see you then with some positive news. Enjoy a bit of early lunch, and then see what happens.